Episode 2711, Come to Me, All Who Are Weary.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive.
Happy, happy day. I hope you're ready for something extraordinary to happen, because I know God has something special for you today. I don't know what the message is, but I want you to open up your heart and clear your mind of all the stuff that's happening around you. I know there are distractions. Come to me, all who are weary. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Matthew 11, verse 28 says this, "Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." Are you tired of running on the hamster wheel of life? Being pulled in all directions, distracted from social platforms, frustrated with society, and exhausted from responsibilities? God is calling you today to come to Him. But what does that really mean? Because how can God pay my bills from heaven? How can God provide me rest when I can't close my eyes? How can God protect me from my enemies at work? How can God purchase my groceries? How can God pass my test? So many questions with no immediate answers. At least that's what our logical, earthly perception tells us. God created the heavens and the earth. God created you, and He can move mountains for you. But what that looks like may be different from what your eyes see. So you have to be willing to walk by faith, knowing in advance that God's got you every step of the way. Nothing is impossible. God said, "Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." I have all that you need. You don't need anything else. But we do try to flood our lives with this stuff that makes us feel better, or attempts to. We fill it with, well, maybe our go-to is indulging in foods. Maybe our go-to is to wear our bodies out at the gym or on our favorite sport. Maybe it's just diving into a book. Maybe it's binge watching on our favorite streaming network. You gotta remember that God shows up differently than we do. So you got to look for the breadcrumbs from heaven, the ones you don't expect or would discount because it wasn't a big enough miracle. Come on, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Sometimes we really have this perception, this preconceived notion that God should be standing right there in the grocery line with us, and He will hand them the $122.36 to pay for groceries, or He's at the gas tank and He's filling it up. You may not physically be able to see God, but I promise you He's doing a mighty work. But we don't give God the opportunity to show up because we're looking for the way we want to see Him, not the way God wants to show us. God does life with you in all the big and the little details of life. He is there, I promise you. But sometimes, you know, what we think and how we dream about things and what we conjure up in our own minds, it really distorts who God is. It distorts how God shows up. It distorts His own words to us from the Bible. Because we sit here and we try to twist things and say, well, He said this, but now He doesn't, so I don't believe anymore. I'm going to walk away. I promise you God's there. The problem is we're not showing up the way God wants us to. And yeah, my friend, we have the issue. It's not about pointing fingers today, but it's a realization that we have got to wake up and realize that the world does not have our answers. Only God does. And so my prayer for you is that God will restore that God will renew and rejuvenate your mind, body, and spirit, not just today, but every day. So get off that hamster wheel. You don't have to be exhausted. Give your body time to cry out for restoration. Give your mind the words of Christ to renew your soul. And give your spirit the opportunity to experience God's presence as He rejuvenates you. Don't be fooled by the ways of this world. Monday doesn't have to be a drag. And Friday, well, it isn't your only day of salvation. Rise to the call God has on your life. Be still and know His presence. Remember, He said it best, "Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." May you find that in Him today and every day. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed week. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.